It's a lovely bay run, isn't it, mate?
Mate, I can't wait to show you the amazing view. Like, this bay run, it shits on the actual bay run. It's called the Bass Hill Bay Run. Ready to see it? This view is amazing. Like, show them the view.
Mate, look at this pond. It's just a pond. I don't know how else to explain
it. It's a pile of shit. The Lebbie vlogs.
Till you see the view. Wait till you see the view. Let's see what everyone's up to. Good morning, everyone. Yeah, this fucking happens every morning.
The latest hot topic is the protest that went on yesterday. Look, I didn't go to the protest, but I'm not gonna lie, I saw a lot of people that went. Some of it got out of control. You could argue that it wasn't right, you know, it was a selfish act. A lot of people shouldn't have went. It's just gonna make things worse. Lockdown's gonna be extended till December. Gladys is not gonna be happy. I mean, what did you guys expect from a Maui going there and preaching freedom, freedom, freedom? Cuz, it's not gonna work. There was, however, a few moments that was twisted by the media, like the guy punching the horse. I mean, I saw it first. I saw a picture of a guy punching a horse. Clearly, the guy didn't really punch the horse. He just pushed it away because the horse was walking towards him. There was a lot of stuff twisted by the media. The cop that copped the ink. I mean, I saw a video of him shaking hands with the protesters. But all in all, I feel like we're just gonna get extended and watch when we see. Everyone's like probably waiting for the Gladys B announcement right now at 11 a.m.
Just before I start the day, I like to remind myself, life is beautiful.
Oh, wait, it's not. Fuck!
Apparently this guy's a barista.
Yalla, part-time show us coffee barista at home. And
brother, you done one course in the city. What are you
loving that? You gotta
just
hit it.
Just fucking do it.
You gotta hit it with the chocolate sprinkles,
alright?
Oh,
let's go.
Once you make the coffee, it's not like that. You don't just finish there, alright?
Yeah, alright.
You come here.
Alright, fuck it, let's go.
About 180 degrees and give it 5 taps.
Just tap it in. Just tap it in. Give it a little tappy.
Bro, you got half of it on the tray.
That's it. That's it.
COVID case predictions for today, given the protests yesterday. I reckon it's too soon for the cases to rise because obviously none of them got tested and it's too soon to spread it. But I think it's just going to be about 115. That's what I reckon.
Yeah, fair enough, mate.
All right, what's your prediction?
Listen, mate, when it comes to COVID, you got to take in a lot of consequences and events that have happened. Right. And according to, you know, you've seen the march, about 3,500.
Right.
So I'm predicting the cases to be about 50,765.
What? Bro, what are you talking about, man?
What, really? Alright, Dad, what do you think the case numbers are going to be, Hala, for Gladys?
I think maybe...
Dad, why are you talking like an import? It's not a skit, Hala, alright, just use your normal voice.
Oh, okay.
He thought it was a skit.
Oh, it's fucking ridiculous. In all seriousness, it was ridiculous what happened yesterday, so I reckon maybe 2,000.
2,000 cases?
Yeah.
Wow, alright, we'll see.
Now listen, I've done jiu-jitsu for about a couple months. You see right now, he's got full guard. So right now, he's got to open his guards. He's got to look for a submission. He's got to attack from the bottom because, you know,
Habib.
You don't want to be on the bottom and get pounded on.
Jab like that.
Yeah.
You see how you slip? He should have went straight in for the uppercut.
But he could have also,
go for the jab.
Yeah, like that. And that went to the body like that. That's what he could have done as well.
What about when he went for the guillotine? It was pretty tight. Like, what's he going to do from the guillotine? You know what I mean?
Why are you doing a hard?
What do you mean?
I'm not. Why are you doing a hard?
What do you mean, I'm not?
Well, there we have it, guys. 141 cases. I think I was the closest.
I was quite close, you know. 765.
What? Bro, what are you talking about, man?
So I thought I'd give people a bit of a tour of the Lebbie podcast. Fucking, this is where it all happens, mate.
This is where it all happens.
All right, look at this. Oi, by the way, that monitor's there. It's because I'm working from home in the podcast studio. How fucking funny is that?
That's funny.
Got a bit of a crowd. Look how shit these chairs are.
This is where the crowd sits, so you know you can sit, enjoy the best podcast in the area.
Yeah, and then you can. So what we usually do is we have the guests sit here, and then the guest is meant to walk onto here. So what they do is they'll sit here awkwardly while me and him talk shit for the first.
But you know what's more awkward is when the guest sits here first and we try and tell them
demonstrate. The guest would usually be sitting like here and then like we'll be discussing with the guest before like, oh yeah, this is what we're going to talk about this week. And then it's like, all right. And then I'll be sitting there and I'll be telling the guest like, all right, let's, you know, you got to... And they never get the point. That's the thing, they never get the point.
Tell me your mum's a teacher without telling me your mum's a teacher. We have a full IWB functional in the garage, but we still watch on this TV. When are we going to fix it, cuz? When are we going to fix it?
Welcome to your new host.
Wait, so we're doing a podcast? Oh, we're doing a podcast, that's it.
No, this is a new host. What are you doing?
What do you mean, your new host?
Who are you?
Excuse me, relax.
Who are you? This is my podcast.
Are you being serious?
Yeah, guys, so this is your new host, Moses Ismail. Welcome to my podcast.
Who's your guest? Who the fuck's your guest, huh? Who's your guest?
I don't need a guest. This is my podcast, brother. This is my podcast.
All right, relax.
You want to go? Relax.
Fucking relax.
We're getting desperate because obviously coronavirus. I ran out of guests. Lockdown. So I want to introduce our new guest, Moe from the area. How are you, mate?
Thanks for inviting me on, Kaz. Look, it's a pleasure to be on the Lebbie podcast. Moe here. I've got to say, your studio's a bit catfish, Kaz. It looks better on YouTube, straight out.
How the hell did these go from Greenacre to here? Look at them. Little bin chickens, mate.
Look, ladies and gentlemen, I've been hyping yous up for this. I want to show you the Basil Bay Run. I want to show you how beautiful it is. Amazing scenery. As you can see in the back there, there's a COVID testing facility. If you have COVID, you can come get tested. Come to the Basil Bay Run. Let's go.
It's a lovely bay run, isn't it, mate?
Mate, I can't wait to show you the amazing view. Like, this bay run, it shits on the actual bay run. It's called the Basil Bay Run. Ready to see it? This view is amazing, like, stunning, breathtaking. All right, show them the view. It's a pile of shit.
You gotta blend in with the locals, you gotta just run.
This is what we run through every day. Is that an accurate presentation of fucking how much you run? He's not even exaggerating, that's how much you actually run.
What's the chances that I actually go and dive in there and find the body? Like, bro, I genuinely think 60%. The chances are pretty high. By the way, you've also got a nice home on the bay, bro. $1 million right there.
Yep, that's $1 million.
Perfect,
dollars,
spacious. Perfect spacious. Two bedroom.
You know, you got the
potential for a granny flat.
So this is a park I played soccer as a kid. Even this guy, fucking under 10s or something, under 11. Man, it brings back so many memories.
Favorite part right here, man, brings back a lot of memories. You know how in Rocky, they have the Philadelphia steps where like he runs up the stairs and then at the end, he's like putting his hands up and he's happy and he's like, you know, he's accomplished something. For me, this was the Rocky Steps.
What happened there, champ?
Fucking never doing that again. Bro, you know what? I've got an idea.
Yeah.
How about we do our own Olympics, given that we're watching the Olympics. Let's do the Ismail Olympics. What we do is Dad holds the slipper, the shahaito, and tries to throw it at us at close range. First one to three is out.
That might be the smartest idea you've ever came up with.
Let's fucking do it.
Do it. Alright, first up, first contestant.
Oh no, this is scary, man.
On your marks. Get set. Go! Got him. Next, we got Mahmoud.
I got a tactic. Ready, set, go.
Oh! Alright, round two. When you're ready, set, go. Oh, missed. Here's the second turn. Big man. Oh, now we got third lucky. Let's go. This time. Oh, he's gone.
Happy to get my gold medal. As you can see, gold medal right here. You know, the opponent was good, but not good enough on the day. As you can see, he's still
can't hack his foot.
As I was saying, you know, good to get a gold medal. As you can see, another sore loser here. Mate, what the? Take three. Look,
mate,
the gold medal.
Mate.
The real speech. We're not going to get hit anymore. I'm happy to get the gold medal. I think it's been a great opportunity to be in the Olympics. Good.
Mate,
he's still, throwing. What do you want?
My leg wasn't 100%, mate.
Now you're coming with excuses. So he reckons he can hit us with a double, but as we're both running at the same time. I think it's utter bullshit. Let's try. Let's go.
What happened?
Mate, I think we proved a lot of things today.
We're terrible vloggers.
We'll never vlog again. Thanks for watching though. 20,000 damn.
bitches on the island. 20,000 dead bitches going private. Mm, she make it clap. I got the strap. 21 gap.
Oh no.